Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
Om Namo Bhagavate
Vasudevaya.
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
Reading Srimad Bhagavad Gita, chapter 18, Perfection of Renunciation, text number 39. Yat agre chanu bandhe cha. Shukam. Shukam mohanam atmana.
Shukam mohanam atmana.
Nidralashya pramadottam.
Nidralashya pramadottam.
Tatamasam udaritam.
Tatamasam udaritam.
Yad agre Chanu bandecha,
yadave chanu bandecha,
sukam mohanam atmana,
sukam mohanam atmana,
nidralashya pramadotam,
nidralashya pramadotam,
tatamasam udaritam,
tatamasam udaritam.
Yat ugre chanu bandecha.
Yat ugre chanu bandecha.
Sukam mohanam atmana.
Sukam mohanam atmana.
Nidralashya pramadottam.
Nidralashya pramadottam.
Tatamasam udaritam.
Tatamasam udaritam.
Yadagre chanu bandhe cha.
Yadagre chanu bandhe cha.
Sukham mohanam atmana.
Sukham mohanam atmana.
Nidralashya pramadottam.
Nidralashya pramadottam.
Tatamasam udaritam.
Tatamasam udaritam.
Yadagre chanu bandhe cha.
Yad agre chanu bandhe cha.
Sukham mohanam atmana.
Sukham mohanam atmana.
Nidralashya pramadottam.
Nidralashya pramadottam.
Tatamasam udaritam.
Tatamasam udaritam.
Yat,
that which
agre
in the beginning
cha
also
anubande
at the end
cha
also
sukham
happiness
mohanam
illusory
atmana
of the self
nidra
sleep
Alashya,
laziness,
Ramada,
an illusion,
Utam,
produced of,
Tat,
that,
Tamasam, in the mode of ignorance,
Udaritam,
is said to be. Translation, and that happiness which is blind to self-realization, which is delusion from beginning to end, and which arises from sleep, laziness, and illusion, is said to be of the nature of ignorance. Nidutai, get the book. Lazy man. Chapter 18. Sibek, Vanti Sibek. No.
Bhoti.
Bhoti Sibek. Buddhisattva Srok, Samsip Kao.
Samsip Kao.
What's he doing?
He's going to be the judge.
What do you see?
Samsip
Kao.
ความหลงผิดตั้งแต่จนต้นจนจบซึ่งเกิดจากการนอนการความเกียจคร้านและความหลงกล่าวว่าเป็นธรรมชาติแห่งอวิชชา One who takes pleasure in laziness and in sleep is certainly in the mode of darkness, ignorance. And one who has no idea how to act and how not to act is also in the mode of ignorance. For the person in the mode of ignorance, everything is illusion. There is no happiness, either in the beginning or at the end. For the person in the mode of passion, there might be some kind of ephemeral happiness in the beginning, and at the end, distress. But for the person in the mode of ignorance, there is only distress, both in the beginning and at the end.
ผู้ที่ไม่รู้ว่าอะไรควรทำอะไรไม่ควรทำก็อยู่ในระดับอวิชชาเช่นกันบุคคลที่อยู่ในระดับนี้ทุกสิ่งทุกอย่างคือความหลงไม่มีความสุขทั้งในตอนต้นหรือตอนจบบุคคลที่อยู่ในระดับตัณหาอาจมีความสุขอยู่บ้างในตอนต้นและยังไม่ยั่งยืนและจะเป็นความทุกข์ในตอนจบแต่สำหรับบุคคลในระดับอวิชชาจะมีแต่ความทุกข์เพียงอย่างเดียวตั้งแต่ตอนจนจบ
Om-ma-gyan-dhra-dhra-dhra-dhra-syā-gyanan-janā-chalākāyā Chakṣur-nilitanyena tasmai śrī-guru-ve-namaha Śrī-caitanya-mano-viṣṭam stāpitam yena-bhūtale Swayam-rupa-kadhamāyam tadāti svāpadantikam Bandeham Shri Guru Shri Yata Pada Kamalam Shri Karan Vaishnavamsya Shri Rupam Sakrajatam Sahagana Raghunathan Vitam Tam Sachevam Sarvaitam Sarvadutam Parichana Sahitam Krishna Chaitanya Devam Shri Radha Krishna Padan Sahagana Lalita Shri Vishakha Nitamstya Hey Krishna Karana Sindhu Dinabandhu Jagatpate Gopesha Gopika Kanta Radha Kanta Namastate Tapta Kanchana Gorange Radhe Vrindavaneshwari Vrishabhanu Sute Devi Pranamami Hari Priye Vancha Kaupataru Vyashya Kripa Sindhu Bhayevacha Patitanam Pavanevyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namaha Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar, Shri Vasadi Kaur Bhaktavinda, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So the 18th chapter is a summary of the teachings of the Bhagavad Gita.
บทที่สิบแปดเกี่ยวกับสรุปบทที่สิบแปด
You have to pay attention. Come on, stop looking at the book. Concentrate. So Lord Krishna is explaining about the effects of the modes of nature on different qualities.
Om Krishna kamlang bopon katok kiyawat kunapaw kong kiyawat tamasha.
He's explaining about happiness in the modes.
Kamlang po kiyawat kwangsu
samrata.
So happiness in the mode of goodness was described that in the beginning it's like poison, but gradually it becomes nectar. Then happiness in the mode of passion was described that in the beginning it's like nectar, but quickly it becomes poison. Now happiness in ignorance is being described, that it is simply suffering, misery from beginning to end. And Krishna describes the things which bring this happiness in the mode of ignorance. He mentions that their happiness comes from sleep.
Krishna was coming along, you are constantly teaching for the poor, constantly.
It's the nature of the mode of ignorance for people to sleep. I was just reading today, Prabhupada was in Perth in Australia, and Shrutakirti, Prabhupada's servant, was cooking lunch for Prabhupada, and he would cook a lot of prasadam, and the devotees who were with Prabhupada, there was a sannyasi called Paramahamsa and Shrutakirti, and there was one other Australian devotee, Jai Dharma, and they would all eat, after Prabhupada, they would eat the remnants, and there was a lot of remnants, they would eat a lot. But then, after they eat a lot, then they would sleep. So Prabhupada saw them sleeping, he was very upset. And he said, the ordinary karmis, the materialistic people, they're not sleeping, they're working all day. And you're the devotees, and you're simply eating and sleeping. So Prabhupada said, bring a book. And the devotee went and brought the book and he said, now read. And so then they began reading, and there was a discussion, questions and answers. And then this way all the devotees who had been sleeping, they gave up their ignorance. So Prabhupada showed them how to avoid this ignorance of sleep. important thing. You should use your time for hearing. Not only hearing, but discussing the topics of Krishna. So also, laziness is also the happiness in the mode of ignorance. When people supposed to do something, they don't do it, that's laziness. And if they feel happy, they think, I was supposed to do it, I didn't do it. They feel proud that they didn't do it. This is their ignorance. So this happiness in ignorance is simply just suffering, it's just simply illusion from beginning to end. There's no it is not real happiness at all. And there's no thought of self-realization. They never even consider that there's any higher purpose in life. They're simply thinking life is meant to satisfy the senses. Eating all kinds of horrible food. And drinking all kinds of disgusting things. And then sleeping. So Prabhupada was always careful to control his sleep. He was only sleeping a couple of hours a day. He would wake up in the middle of the night and then begin to write his purports. If Prabhupada had not conquered over his sleeping, we wouldn't have all the books that we have today. So the Goswamis of Vrindavan, they're also described like that, that they conquered over eating and sleeping. Nidrahara vihara kadi vijito chaitanya divyocha. Divyahara, right? Which verse is it? Anyway, it's one of the verses. Nidrahara vihara kari vijito chaitanya divyoka bande rupa sanatano ragujato shri jiva pavaya shri goranga gunana varna dosha dasa nitya paputapani kintano tanubritam govinda ganami. The sixth verse, samkhya purvaka nama gana natibika lovasani kito Nidrahara vihara kadi vijito chaitan dino chayo Radha Krishna gunasmriter madurima nandena mata alika bande rupa sanatano raguja guru shikiva. So the Goswamis conquered over eating and sleeping. Eating and sleeping is the business of the animals.
อาการนอนเขาบอกว่าอาการนอนก็คือเหมือนกับการใช้ชีวิตของสัตว
์ Right we say sleep like a bear
นอนเหมือนกับหมี
If you go to Russia there's many bears there in the forest
ถ้าเราไปรัสเซียที่ป่ารัสเซียเนี่ยจะมีหมีเยอะมาก
And they can go into, they find a tree, a hollow in the tree, and they get in that hollow of the tree, and they stay in that tree, and they can sleep for months. Yeah, because very cold. So they take shelter in the tree. So if you want to sleep, next life you'll become a bear. Then you can really enjoy your sleep.Prabhupada said sleeping is like death because when you sleep then you forget about Krishna we're not thinking of Krishna so we want to keep ourselves alert in the service of KrishnaOne time, Prabhupada was giving the class and he saw some devotee was sitting there with the eyes closed, not moving. And Prabhupada said, you're asleep! And the devotee said, Prabhupada, I'm not asleep!
Prabhupada in Sao Kamang Nang Lakta Yo High class.
Prabhupada said, if your eyes are closed and you're not moving, you're asleep. So Prabhupada had his standards, what he wanted. I have to be careful to try to please.Srila
Prabhupada.
So laziness also is another problem. Lazy, we grow long hair, we don't worry about cleanliness, we don't.Put on tilak and all these things. This is all laziness. We don't chant our rounds. Laziness.
การไว้ผมการไม่อาบน้ำการไม่สวมทิลักหรือว่าสวมนั่นนั่นคือการเกียรติคาน
So Prabhupada wants us to keep the standards.
Prabhupada ตั้งกฎกับเรา
We have to try to increase, we have to do better, do more hearing and chanting. People always want to do less, they always want to minimize, they want to do less, they want to come, wake up late, they want to have a simple program, not too long. They think, oh, we shouldn't be too serious, take it easy. It's all laziness. So this is the happiness in the mode of ignorance.
ความสุขในระดับความไม่รู้
And happiness in the mode of ignorance is just simply madness. It results in illusion, madness. And if you die in the mode of ignorance, the next life you'll become an animal, or you take birth in the lower species, or go to hell. So a devotee does not want to associate with the mode of ignorance. We want to cultivate the mode of goodness. From the mode of ignorance, how will we? It will be very difficult to perform devotional service. If we are in the mode of ignorance, then we will stay in the material world. We'll never get the goal of life. We'll have to enter some hellish condition of life. So we have this rare human body, we have to use it carefully. We have to use it for the service of Krishna. We have to follow the rules and regulations. Rules and regulations are there for the human beings, for the civilized people. There's no rules and regulations for the dogs and the cats and the hogs and the birds and the squirrels. But we have the human life, we are fortunate souls. We have to take advantage of this rare opportunity. In the association of devotees, not only do we have the human body, but we have also association with devotees. I was just reading a nice pastime in the Vyasa Puja book. I was reading there. One devotee wrote, he was describing about this one devotee's name. My god brother is named Dhananjaya. So Prabhupada told him, your name means conqueror of wealth.
Conqueror means one who can, one who has all the money.
And Prabhupada said, money's everywhere. Money is everywhere. You just have to learn the art, how to grab it, how to get it. So then Dhananjaya said, Prabhupada, I was reading in Srimad Bhagavatam, it said there's in the Himalayas there's mountains of gold. He said, is this true, Prabhupada?
True.
Prabhupada said, yes, it's true. So he said, Prabhupada, you know where the mountains are? So Prabhupada said, why do you want to know? He said, well, Prabhupada, I'll go there and I'll take a hammer and I'll go and chisel and I'll take some of the gold, I'll take my backpack and I'll bring it back. We can use it for our Krishna conscious programs. But Prabhupada said, no, no, that will create problems. People get too much money, they won't use it. He said, more valuable than gold are devotees. More about gold is the devotees are the real gold. So I said you should make devotees. But then Prabhupada said even more important than making devotees is to train the devotees we have. Train them how to become Krishna conscious. How they can train them to cultivate the mode of goodness. The qualities of a Brahmana. And then they will never give up Krishna conscious. Okay. Any question?
Sometimes many times we hear that we can do devotional service in any mode, right? You know, like you know, even if you're a Sudra or Vaishya, you can still be a devotee. But Prabhupada gives so much emphasis on mode of goodness. So you know, I mean, if you're in other modes, should we try to just come to mode of goodness, or we do devotional service and those modes also become transcendental, or how does it work?
Devotee has to be transcendental. Transcendental, to be transcendental, you have to first situate yourself in the mode of goodness. Just like Arjuna is a Kshatriya, when he has to work, he has to perform his duty in the service of Krishna. So it's not that he's in the mode, because it's a Kshatriya, he's in the mode of passion. He's, you know, he's transcendental. He's doing it for Krishna.
Arjuna chinta, Arjuna bin Kshatriya, bin naklo, naklo, misha pewa, naklo, minkum, yunirada, passion, alada,
tanha.
So in the same way you're working in a job, it doesn't mean you're a Sudra, you're doing it for Krishna. And you have to cultivate the mode of goodness and then come to the transcendental platform. We're not Sudras, we're not Brahman, we're not Kshatriyas or any of these things. We're simply servants of the servant of Krishna.
Sudra, Chitta, Brahmana, Vaishnava, developing Purusha, Purusha, Purusha.
So a devotee of Krishna can do everything, whatever he does it for Krishna. He may do sudra work, he may do vaisha work, but it's all for Krishna. Srimad Bhagavad Gita ki
jai.
Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai